Climbing up the skies in a very, very urgent need to cut the moon in twice, in two halves. So things like that are more interesting. I'd say, yeah, the stories of past times, the story of nowadays is, as a matter of fact, well connected to the moon, honestly. And I think it is our religion. So people, if they're not eating or drinking, they're talking about food, they're buying food, then they're preparing food. The entire life of a lot of buildings is actually serving food around the table, and food is cheap. So I'd like everybody to come from the connected to each other very much. Downstairs because as a matter of fact, since so many years there are wars and there are religions, and the religion is not a stop word. But I think if there is something like business, enormous amount of countries are not following each other because there's a business to maintain, and this food is bringing life to the families and children. So I mean, as far as those food, people are much more peaceful than if we're talking about the differences of Jerusalem and Rome. So I'd like to allow everyone just to dream this dream that all the wars are created because of need of money and because of, not enough food. So I'd like to ask people of the entire world, politician of the entire world, to forget a little bit about religion, to try build up bridges of business based on food between the countries like Israel and Palestine, for example, or Russia and Israel. I think there are just not enough businesses based on food between these countries. This is why there is something like death existing and wars are existing because food is bringing life and buffalo's life and death. So I'd like to ask if you're looking at the war conflict, see that there is a big global food business between these countries. Maybe there's possible food bridge, possible business between as a peacemaker would be a solution good enough. I'm blessing you all. I love you all. Goodbye.